Hi, this is Dawn Prioletti of BreakTheBadBoyHabit.com. And in this video, I want to do some EFT tapping with you for something that you may not think this even applies to you, but I want you to just trust me on this one, because it's something that's very insidious. It's something that may be going on unconsciously, or it may even be a conscious thing. But it's the idea that I can't let go of him, because what if he was like my last chance, my last hope? Like, what if I'm never going to find anybody else? This was my last chance. I'm not getting any younger, you know. And I know intellectually that may sound a little ridiculous, but I'm talking about on a feeling level. And so I want you to just ask your subconscious mind here, not your thinking mind, but your subconscious mind, to give you a number from 0 to 10. And I want you to say a statement out loud. This was my last chance. And how true does that feel? From 0 to 10, with 10 being absolutely true. So maybe you're at a 10, maybe you're at a 0, maybe you're at a 6 or a 7. Even if you, like I said, even if you feel that this doesn't apply to you, I would encourage you to go ahead and do this tapping with me, because you may find that it's buried and it may come up while we're doing the tapping. So on the karate chop point, just go ahead and tap with me. Even though I can't let him go, because there's a part of me that thinks, oh my God, what if this guy was my last chance? After all, I'm not getting any younger. I'm not getting any younger. And, you know, there are so many guys out there are just screwed up anyway. What if I just screwed this up so bad because I didn't know how to set the right boundaries with him? I jumped in and had sex with him too soon. I made so many mistakes. And what if now the price that I'm going to have to pay is that I'm never going to be able to have anybody in my life unless I settle for somebody who's going to be just a friend with benefits, or something that I don't actually want anyway. Even though I do have this fear going on, I choose to love and honor and accept myself anyway. Even though I have this fear that, what if this was my last chance? What if this guy was it for me? Oh my God, I'm terrified that I'm going to be alone for the rest of my life. Maybe I need to try to get this guy back. Oh my God, I'm afraid that I'm going to always have to settle. And that just makes me feel so much despair and so sad. I'm so afraid I'm going to have to settle because I'm too old. I'm not 20 anymore. You know, let's face it. I've got to be realistic. I'm not a 20-year-old anymore. A lot of the opportunities that maybe once were there don't exist anymore. And I may just have to settle for something that isn't really what I want. And I love and accept myself, even though this whole situation sounds totally hopeless. Even though I am so afraid that this may have been my last chance. This guy, this relationship, as pathetic as it was in so many ways, it may have been my last chance at having anything. And part of me says, wow, that really pisses me off. Because how unfair is that? But you know, I'm not a spring chicken anymore, as some people like to remind me. I'm not 20 years old anymore. I have to be realistic. After all, there's not many men out there. There's a shortage of men in the world. Out of the 7 billion people on the planet, God knows he was the only one that I even had half a chance with, and boy, was that a disaster. So I'm just totally screwed. Let's just face it, I'm screwed. I'm going to end up being alone for the rest of my life because the only other option that I have is to just be with someone who wants to use me for sex and isn't going to offer me anything, no kind of commitment, nothing. And I'm just going to have to settle for that. And see, the guys know this. They know that I'm going to have to settle because they know, like I do, that there just isn't that much out there. And this really sucks. But I choose to love and accept myself, even though I really feel that this is it for me. It's over. Now tapping through the points. There is a part of me that really feels like, you know, this was it for me. This was my last chance. And I totally blew it. I did everything wrong that I could have done wrong. I threw myself at him. I acted completely desperate, totally pathetic. And so, yeah, I got used. What the hell did I expect, really? I got used, and I deserve that, because that's what men do to women who act desperate. That's what men do to women who put themselves on a silver platter and offer themselves up sexually without him having to do anything. All he had to do was make a phone call, and I was there. I deserve this. I deserve to be treated like a whore. Let's face it, that's what I deserve. And he was the last chance, the last person on the planet who ever would have wanted to be with me. And I ruined it. I ruined everything, just like I always do. Okay, now I want you to take a couple of deep breaths, and I want to just say to you right now that, you know, I don't have a script for doing these videos at all. I just allow the words to come through me. And sometimes those words are going to sound really harsh. And I know that a lot of you who have studied law of attraction, you're probably thinking, oh my God, I can't say those words. But I want to remind you that EFT tapping is a clearing technique. And what that means is it is clearing all of these emotions that are stored in your body. So what I'm saying are the things that you're feeling anyway, deep down inside of you, but you probably don't want to admit it. But the thing is, when you feel these things and you deny them and you stuff them down, it ends up affecting the choices that you make in your life on an unconscious level. So what I'm doing is I'm bringing all the garbage right up to the surface. Let's put it on the table. Let's look at it, and let's then be able to release it and let it go. You know, you cannot heal what you cannot feel. So that is why I'm bringing it all up. Even all of the ugly stuff that most of us are just shocked, we wouldn't even admit. But the thing is, once you admit it and once you bring it up into the light, doesn't it lose its power over you? So I don't want you to be afraid to say these words, okay? I want you to know that there's no way that I can put something into your energy system that does not naturally belong there. You, at your very core, are a being of light and love, and that's all that you are. So, When I say these things that appear to be the complete opposite of that, I'm saying it in order to bring that up so we can just look at it, and we're tapping on it, we're releasing it from your energy system, okay? So, I hope that you feel a lot of relief from that round, and go back and measure that from 0 to 10 and say the phrase again. What if he was my last chance? And then just measure that again. And then we're going to come back in the next video, and I'm going to do another round of a little bit more positive tapping. We're going to bring your energy vibration up around that. So I'll see you in the next video.